Hi all, and welcome back to the channel. I'm Gary. Thanks for joining in. It's always welcome to have you here. Today, we're going to have a look at the five operating systems you may not know about. We all know about Windows, we all know about macOS, and we know about Linux. But did you know there is a lot of others? A lot more. There are probably hundreds. If you discount most of the Linux variants, and there are a lot of those, there's a lot of operating systems out there. So we're just going to run through a couple of them. So the first one to look at is OpenIndiana, which is derived from Open Solaris. Now, Solaris was discontinued by Oracle a long time ago. Oracle, the database company. And Solaris used to run on massive, massive mainframes. And it's a complete Unix System 5 release. Currently, it's been forked. And it's based on LumeOS. LumeOS is a collection of tools, OpenZFS, a few other bits. So yeah, so it was actually come from Sun Microsystems. If you know Sun Microsystems and Spark servers and stuff like that, going back a long, long way. Good OS, as I say, used to be big mainframes. And these days, the OpenIndiana project is not owned, but it's developed and maintained by the Illuminos Foundation. So there we go. That's the first one. OpenIndiana, worth downloading, giving it a try. I'll put all the links in the description so you can see where you can get them from. OS number two, AROS, which is an Amiga clone, pronounced AROS, not to be mistaken with your bottom. And it was developed to run Amiga games back in 1995, so it's 27 years old, still going strong, open source project. And yep. So if you have a look around this, quite nice. It can run on x86 computers or PowerPC, which is the older Macs. And it also runs on ARM as well. So you can run this on a Raspberry Pi or a few others like that. So yeah, that's based on the Amiga 1200. Looks its age, if I'm honest with you. It's not something that I use. I have no need for that kind of thing. I'm not a game player of a networky sysadmin type geek. So I don't really get to play around with this. Yeah, it's quite a nice little OS. But it does, as I say, look a bit dated. But you know, it's been going for 27 years for the intention of playing games on it. So I guess that will tell you why it looks so old. I guess they're throwing their development into using the API for games and stuff like that. OS number three is Haiku. It's part of the BOS family of operating systems. Its first release in 2009. So this is quite an old one as well, 20 years old. Still in beta, but it's still going. So this is BE Inc. It's a free and open source operating system compatible with BEOS. Development began in 2001, and the operating system became self-hosted in 2008. So it's it broke away a long time ago. Runs on x86 hardware, ARM, Spark, PowerPC again, and Risk V 64. So it'll It'll work on a lot of hardware. So that's pretty good. Got a rather unique interface. Quite like the little box that hangs up off the top that you can close the windows with. It's quite nice. Very minimalistic. Yeah, it's quite nice. Like that. So, OS number 4. React. ReactOS. Now, this is an interesting one. So, this is an open source clone of Windows. Very Windows-like. It's got an emulation level. Got File Explorer. All written in C++. Most of it is written in C. And it's implementing the Windows API functionality, which is quite impressive when you think about it, given that that is all closed source. But yeah, it's quite nice. Runs on the Wine emulation stuff. Yeah, it's been going a long time. Still beta. Actually, it's still alpha. Wow. Okay. I'll have to break into this and really see what it's like. On version 0.4.14. Yeah. It does look very much like, I guess, Windows NT. Windows 2000, maybe. But yeah. Yeah, it's quite a nice one. And then finally, OS number 5, the BSD family. For those of you that have watched my previous videos, I do like FreeBSD. I don't use it for everything. I use it for services. I don't use it as a desktop. Maybe I will one day once I've convinced the family to drop the... but yeah, FreeBSD, what a great operating system. Well-rounded. BSD from Berkeley Software Distribution, which is based on the Berkeley University campus from memory. And it was first released back in 1993. Wow, I was just passing my driving test. It's the most popular of BSD operating systems, FreeBSD. And it's very polished nowadays. We're on version 13. Wow, 13.1 is about to come out, which is quite amazing. Really amazing that it's been going so strong and so long. There are variations of FreeBSD or breakaways. So you've got Open and Net. OpenBSD likes to concentrate on security, which is well received in the community. They do a lot of security stuff, and yeah, they really concentrate on that. And it is good the way they do that. And a lot of it is secure. It's really good. And then there's NetBSD, and they like to port BSD to pretty much every piece of hardware they can find, including toasters, which is quite nice. So from memory, I'm pretty sure that they broke away from 4BSD and took it in a different direction, actually. So NetBSD was originally derived from 4.3BSD, Reno. Yeah, okay. So 4.3. So when did OpenBSD become a thing? Let's have a look at that.
5 hours later.
So there you go, guys. There's 5 operating systems that are not Windows, macOS, or Linux. Might be worth checking them out. They may well fit the bill for what your use case is. If they don't, you can always go back to one of the others. I think I will carry on with my split setup so that I've got my desktop as a Windows PC, which is friendly for the whole house. And then I'll use my services on FreeBSD. And if the need arises, I'll use something else. For instance, if I was to get a Raspberry Pi for setting up a Pi hole or something like that, then I will use the Linux distro that is in conjunction with that one. So there we go. There's a quick breakdown of 5 operating systems that you may not know about. You may do. If you do, kudos to you for exploring other options. hope you find this this slightly different video interesting and informative. If you do, please chuck it a like and subscribe to come back for more content in the future. And I'll see you in the next one. Take care, everyone.